the last known address of Antonio Wright, just a block away and within sight of the Dawson Center, the site of the firebombing of the Dawson family 15 years before. Wright was 11 years old at that time. Now 26, he's earned the title Public Enemy Number One when he allegedly firebombed a house on Greenmount Avenue. Two men, Tyrone James and Shaheem Sholto, died. Six people were injured, including a 38-year-old woman and three of her children. According to charging documents, Wright was identified by witnesses using a photo lineup. The documents don't list motive. Police continue to point to retaliation over the shooting of a man who ran into the house Thursday. That man was not present at the time Molotov cocktails were tossed. Have your detectives interviewed the shooting victim?
Yes, our detectives have spoken to the shooting victim, from the non-fatal shooting victim, who, of course, wasn't in the house.
Wright turned himself in yesterday, proclaiming his innocence on video his wife posted to Facebook. She's also posted video from November, in which Wright claims to be dealing with a city police officer and guns.
The real Baltimore City Police officer about to buy his gun back.
Police are now reviewing the videos. An assault rifle is seen in one, but there is no video of a transaction. Police say the officer reported several personal guns stolen at the time as required. They see no connection to the current cases.
Has that officer had anything to do with investigating Mr. Wright?
No, that officer wasn't involved in this case. And as far as I know, he wasn't involved in any way or had any direct knowledge of who Antonio Wright was prior to being named Public Enemy Number One.
Antonio Wright was convicted of armed robbery in a case in 2012 and served several years in prison. The scene of that crime, right here, same place on Greenmount, he and another man held up a man at knife point. Reporting live tonight from East Baltimore, I'm Jane Miller, WBAL-TV 11 News.
All right, Jane.